I'll be humming this year's song as we go marching all day long. And from a distance you may hear me say, well, it's a beautiful day for a religious protest. A beautiful day for a religious protest. So grab your signs and your suitcase too. We're gonna force the world to hear our religious views. Look at all those sinning sinners. We'll turn all of them to winners. If you're buying, we've got wings to...
This is Ruth Illingworth here outside the Arts Centre, formerly the County Hall in Mullingar, hoping to bring a smile to your face. We look back at some of the more amusing moments in this town's history. The County Hall, as it was known until the 1990s, opened its doors in 1913. It had been long the dream of some local councillors, including Robert Downes, that Mullingar should have a town hall, although some people were sceptical about it and there were references to Downes's playhouse and how much it was going to cost. But work went ahead, the old jail on this site was demolished, and by March 1913 the new hall was opened. The original plan was actually to have it opened by the president of the Gaelic League and future president of Ireland, Dr. Douglas Hyde, but that didn't actually happen. There was a row about proposals to charge people to come to hear Dr. Hyde perform the opening ceremony, and grumblings that people were already paying enough for the hall without having to pay to go inside it to hear it being opened. So the first show in the hall, it began, there was a ball featuring the Westmeath Hunt Ball and the orchestra from the Yorkshire Light Infantry Regiment and the barracks played at that. A number of local plays were put on by the drama companies in the town. And then there was the first film show. Cinema was just coming to Mullingar then, and indeed there was a cinema in this hall for many years. The show that was put on at Easter 1913 was A Life of Our Lord, called From the Manger to the Cross. It had been filmed in Egypt by a French company, but the film show attracted some adverse publicity. As people arrived for the show, they met a line of pickets. The picketers were complaining about the fact that the actress playing Our Lady was divorced, and they felt that this was deeply insulting to the Catholic faith and to Our Lady's memory, and so they stood outside and protested while the film was shown inside. But despite the protesting picketers, the show went ahead, and indeed the film came back and was shown again in Mullingar some years later, and this time there doesn't appear to have been any protest at all. But that was the first film show, and From the Manger to the Cross was considered to be quite a fine film for its day. And curiously enough, well, the local clergy and bishop, who were normally very vigilant about what was shown and put on stage here, seemed to raise no objections at all. The protesters were all lay people. It may be said in later years, in the 1920s, when the hall here was one of the venues in Mullingar for dances, and particularly from the 20s onwards, some of the new dances and waltzes and things, that the then Bishop of Meath, Bishop Garran, objected. He seems to have regarded dancing as an occasion of sin, and that those going to dances needed to be careful of their immortal souls, because dance leads to sin. However, despite the bishop's concerns, most of his flock continued to attend dances here. In the 1950s, there was another problem when the County Council in 1956 voted by 12 votes to 8 to ban what they described as jitterbugging from the hall. This was when rock and roll was beginning to arrive. It was the year of skiffle. The councillors don't seem to be quite clear about what this new kind of dancing and music was, except that they didn't like it. So they voted by a majority to ban it. One of the councillors, incidentally, who voted against a ban was Patrick Lenehan, the father of Mary O'Rourke and Brian Lenehan Sr. The ban doesn't seem to have lasted very long, and within a year the hall was playing host to the beginnings of the show band era. Bands like the Clipper Charlton and others were performing here, and of course a few years later Joe Dolan began to appear on the in the hall here, along with many other acts of the 1960s. But and so there were occasions during its history when there seems to have been moral objections to the kind of music and the kind of dance and the kind of films that were shown here. It may also add that back in the early 1900s, before this hall opened, there was a show put on in, I think it was the parochial hall round in Church Avenue, and the town commissioners insisted on looking at the script of the play and rewriting parts of it before allowing it to go ahead. So the County Hall here remains a great entertainment venue, but as I said, back in 1913 it did attract sort of pickets to complain about what was seen as the immorality of having a divorced woman playing Our Lady in a film about Our Lord. So this is Ruth Illingworth, hoping to keep you smiling during this pandemic crisis of 2020. Thank you.